Welcome to CamLook, your daily dose of the Cincinnati Art Museum. Every weekday at 10 a.m., a staff member or volunteer will be sharing an object from the permanent collection and posing questions for discussion. Be sure to check back every day for a new work and a new chat. My name is Kristen Vincenti, and I am the assistant to the director. Today we will be looking at the daguerreotype Karnak Temple, Thebes, Egypt, by Joseph Philibert Gerald de Prigny. This apparently unassuming piece of metal is the oldest photograph in the museum's collection, and one of the earliest surviving photographs of Egypt. Born to a wealthy landowning family in Langres, France on October 21, 1804, de Prigny was an artist, architectural historian, archaeologist, and pioneer photographer. He first came to prominence in the 1830s for several studies of medieval Islamic architecture in Spain and Italy, which were illustrated with prints made after his drawings and watercolors. Also in the mid-1830s, de Prigny exhibited at least one painting based on his study of the Alhambra. Thus, even before the inception of photography, he had been connecting travel, scholarship, and amateur artistic activity in a manner that followed the Enlightenment tradition of the Grand Tour. He subsequently learned the daguerreotype process, and in 1841 took his cumbersome camera equipment from France to Egypt, just 2 years after the invention of the medium. Here's a diagram of the daguerreotype process, to emphasize how cumbersome this would have been. For more information on this process, be sure to check out the link to the Metropolitan Museum of Art in the post. De Prigny then pursued his research on a three-year photographic excursion around the Eastern Mediterranean. He returned to France in early 1845 with 1,000 daguerreotypes, including the earliest surviving photographs of Greece, Egypt, Turkey, Syria, and Jerusalem, and among the first daguerreotypes depicting Italy. A scholar and an artist, his pictures reflect a pioneering effort to merge the documentary capacity of the camera with the expressive potential of the photographic image. Although Gerald de Prigny was actually the third person to make photographs in Egypt, his are the only of these early pictures to survive today. Surprisingly, Gerald de Prigny's work was effectively unknown until a cache of his daguerreotypes was discovered in an attic at the end of the 20th century. Be sure to check back tomorrow for another CamLook at a work from the Cincinnati Art Museum's permanent collection.